وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. This is Brother Ziyad with the kunya of Abu Dharr from the Ruqya services, with in collaboration with the brother Adnan, my colleague from the Ruqya services. We decided, inshallah ta'ala, today to shoot for you a video talking about the Ruqya and the concept of the Ruqya from the Aqidah point of view and from the Sharia point of view, and as well self-Ruqya, and as well how to perform what we call the basics of the Ruqya on yourself and your family. The reason why we decided to shoot a video of today is because we receive a lot of messages on YouTube and on our Facebook page with the brothers and sisters asking, how can I perform Ruqya? Or like, I have a sister, I have a brother, I have a mother, they are suffering from that, what shall I do? And inshallah ta'ala, Allah put blessings in our work and we explain to you everything. First of all, we have to explain what is the meaning of Ruqya, what it is Ruqya. The Ruqya, actually, it's a word that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran from Surah Al-Qiyamah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أعوذ بالله الشيطان الرجيم وَقِيلَ مَنْ رَاقُ. Allah mentioned the word Ruqya in the Surah Al-Qiyamah. And when somebody will ask near the person who's passing away, وَقِيلَ مَنْ رَاقُ, and it will be said, who can cure? So it's rooted from the verb of the word Ruqya, Raq, Raqa, Yarqi. Now, very sadly, many brothers and sisters, especially the elders, believe that us, we are kind of like we have special power or we have a special knowledge. We're not. The Ruqya is based upon this, using Al-Quran Al-Kareem as a way for treatment and using the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the Sunnah. Basically, the Ruqya, we're back again. This is Brother Ziyad from the Ruqya services. This is Brother Adnan. Basically, here we will use Brother Adnan as a patient or somebody who will receive the Ruqya. Now, we're gonna show you first, inshallah ta'ala, the basis how to do Ruqya on somebody else. But in order to do Ruqya on somebody else, number one commandment or important information or advice, you should be on Udhu, and the person who is receiving the Ruqya should be in a state of Udhu. It's very vital, we should be clean before performing the Ruqya. You should sit the person in a chair, in a very comfortable position, and ask them to put the hands in the knee as very relaxed body, because your body, the body language of the patient, will mean a lot to you, because you're gonna look what's happening here. Now, for the person who performed the Ruqya, and the Raqi should have three major points. Number one, should believe that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can cure. Number two, having tawakkul, inshallah ta'ala, and indeed on the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, have the certainty, have the yaqeen, that when you're going to recite on somebody, if there is something there to do with the unseen world, like evil eye or like jinn, symptoms will show. And number three, inshallah ta'ala, do it as act of ibadah, act of worship, because you apply the Quran. And the patient should, number one, receive from you the Quran, relying only on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The patient shouldn't think that you are reciting the Quran on this brother, and you have got the solution or the healing. The patient should believe and know that it's only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who cured with his word. And the patient should not think much, because what happened is when you're reciting, if the person not listen to the Quran with certainty, with tranquility, you will be like sound passing by. So ask the person who you read the Quran on to listen to you really attentively. So what you do, you say the person nicely, you tell them to relax, inshallah ta'ala. You are in a state of udhu. You can put your right hand in the forehead and your left hand in the chest. Not necessarily you lie them on the floor. That's optional. That's only for us Raqi to measure the body of the measure the movement of the body, to look at it very closely. But you hear all what you're doing, close friend, close member of the family, you read the Quran on them, they are suffering from something or they're not feeling comfortable. So you put your hands here, your hand here, your hand here, inshallah ta'ala, or only one hand, you have a deep breath, you tell them, please have to work with Allah, and you do adhan first. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. You start with the adhan, yeah? Because the jinni don't like the adhan. Here, I forgot to mention something before you start doing this. You better always ask this person what you're suffering from. Dreams. Do you see snakes or do you see dogs in your dreams? Mainly. Do you see yourself flying in the dreams? Like you are taken off and flying. Do you see yourself falling from the air to the ground in your dreams? Huh? Do you see yourself chased in the dreams? Like there's a tall shadow with not known face and chasing you. Do you see yourself in your dreams, lots of blood around you? Do you yourself in your dreams, there's like evil stuff happening to you all the time? But these dreams, we cannot take a ruling from it. But what we say, we try to have signs from it. After that, we ask the person about some physically informations that we ask on them. For example, what are they, inshallah? If it's a case of black magic, we will have
pins and needles.
Pins and needles in the toes or in the fingers or in the toes. What else?
Palpitations.
Lower back problem. What else?
Headaches.
We will have headaches, shoulder pain, joint pain. Sometimes if the magic is in the tummy, we will have
some stomach pain
unexplained medically. And the main thing, the person will be listening to the Quran with a bit of dislike. So what you do? Simple, don't try to be acting like a doctor. We're not doctors, we're just Muslims helping other Muslims. You put your hand here, and this is just quickly to diagnose and apply the Quran. We do the adhan, and straight from the adhan, we give the Durood Sharif. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama sallayta Allahum. We give the Durood Sharif upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Salat al-Ibrahimiyya. And then straight away, what we do? We engage with Surah Al-Fatiha. And don't forget the isti'adah. A'udhu billahi minash shaitan ar-rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. And we recite Surah Al-Fatiha. Recite as much as you wish, inshallah ta'ala, as is the mother of the book. Straight after Surah Al-Fatiha, you can stop and ask the patient, how did you feel when I recited Surah Al-Fatiha? Is your heart beating faster? How did you feel when I recited Surah Al-Fatiha? Any like scratches in the skin or like any movement of heat or cold going above the skin? Any feeling of like ants going ups and down in the skin? Did you feel like you don't want to listen to the Quran from me? You see, stuff like this we're looking for. We're looking for the patient to be uncomfortable. Show us what the patient will be uncomfortable with when we recite Surah Al-Fatiha on them. They should act like getting uncomfortable, don't want to listen to the Quran. Actually, you can tell from the body language, they're not that much comfortable. So there, you tell them, please listen to me more. And you engage with the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alif lam mim. Thalika al-kitabu la rayba fih. The beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. And what you do between each verse and recite Surah Al-Fatiha, you blow the air like this. Basically, you're blowing the Quran on the person. In any time, you finish the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah to the part where Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. What you do? You recite Ayat al-Kursi. اللَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الْحَيُّ الْقَيُّمُ. You blow on the patient. Ayat al-Kursi, the three quls. This is, three quls means Surah Al-Falaq. Surah Al-Ikhlas, Surah Al-Falaq, Surah Al-Nas. This is for you just to apply Quran on this brother or this sister for some kind of relief. At any time of this sign we're going to show you now appear, then stop and go see a Raqi. For example, the hands start shaking badly. Show us very close to the camera. The hands start doing this movement. Or up and down. And then more you recite, the up and the shaking goes deeper and harder. Show us. Hard. Like a proper case, you see, yeah? Like it's going like this. Or both hands. Both hands, show us. Both hands are going very bad. Huh? Or both hands shaking and doing some weird movement with the fingers. In that case, means there is definitely something to do with black magic or jinn here. You have to stop, inshallah ta'ala, and go seek an attention from a raqi. Here, what we showed you is how you apply the Quran on a person close to you, inshallah ta'ala. to find out, are they okay, are they not, after all what they're suffering from, inshallah ta'ala. Now, another part, inshallah ta'ala, and a different video, we will show you, what do you recite if it is an evil eye? What do you recite or you treat if it is a case of sihr? And what do you, inshallah ta'ala, recite and use if it is a case of jinn possession, out of love or out of dhulm, you know, he's oppressing the human being, and all that. Now we showed you how you, as a human, just diagnose another Muslim or help him, but instead of wudu, tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yaqeen, certainty that the Qur'an is powerful, put the hands here, you know, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, adhan, darud sharif, Surah Al-Fatiha, blowing between, inshallah ta'ala, see how the person feels physically, and before you can ask them about dreams they have, mainly dogs, snakes in the dream, monsters, shadows following them, falling from a high sky, flying. Main thing is when you recite in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayat Al-Kursi and the three quls, and you have any of the movement we showed you, the body getting a bit uncomfortable, show us body shake, inshallah ta'ala, and leg shake. The legs go very, very high. Something like this. Actually, it's quicker than this. The brother is not possessed yet. But as you see, it's more than this, inshallah ta'ala. So what we say, if we have any of these cases, stop, don't go forward, inshallah ta'ala. Go seek help of a raqi, and they will tell you what to do next. Now, inshallah ta'ala, we will show you what to do to apply Quran on yourself as a form of raqi. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to do this before bed. I put the hands together and I recite Surah Al-Fatiha, and I recite Ayat Al-Kursi, and I recite Al-Ikhlas, Al-Falaq, Al-Nas three times, and I blow in my hands like and then what I do, then I pass all over my body. In other language, it's like I am wiping all my body with that. That's before sleep, and don't forget Ayat al-Kursi. Now, if you are finding some symptoms to do with jinn or sihr in yourself, then the best way to apply the Qur'an is be in wudu, have the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sit in a calm place, open the Qur'an from Surah Baqarah, from a special area from the Qur'an where Allah speaks about sihr, which we're gonna cover in another session inshallah ta'ala, and have isti'adha and read the Quran with attention of
healing.
Louder, please, with attention of
healing,
shifa. The Quran al-Kareem is the most powerful. So what you do, you read it for attention of healing. Oh Allah, have mercy on me. This is only the basics. But don't forget, one of the basics that you have to do is reading your adhkar, your remembrance of the morning and the afternoon, which can be found very easily online, or a very beautiful special little book called Husn al-Muslim, The Fortress of a Muslim. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we shared with you the basics how you should apply ruqya on yourself and on others. The field is very big. It's not an easy field, inshallah ta'ala. Us, we still learning for ourselves, and it's a field of learning forever. But at any time, please don't try to take so much. Take more than what you can do, inshallah ta'ala, and read your Qur'an, practice your Qur'an, and read on each other's Qur'an as a matter of prevention and as a matter of cure. But remember, prevention is better than cure. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.